ओके सर, तो गुड मॉर्निंग मलिक। ओके, वी वर ऑन कंपनी ऑडिट। ओके, इन कंपनी ऑडिट वी स्टार्टेड विद द कंटेंट, इफ यू रिमेंबर, विद योर क्वालिफिकेशन एंड डिस्क्वालिफिकेशन ऑफ ऑडिटर। क्वालिफिकेशन वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस, डिस्क्वालिफिकेशन जस्ट आई एम रिफ्रेशिंग द कंटेंट विच वी डिस्कस यस्टरडे। फर्स्ट पॉइंट इज बॉडी कॉर्पोरेट नहीं बन सकता, ऑफिसर एम्प्लॉय ऑफ ए कंपनी नहीं बन सकता, पर्सन हु इज ए पार्टनर और एम्प्लॉय ऑफ ए ऑफिसर और एम्प्लॉय ऑफ कंपनी नहीं बन सकता। ओके, आफ्टर दैट वी डिस्कस PPR, पर्सन पार्टनर और रिलेटिव। ओके, एंड वी हैव डिस्कस थ्री थिंग्स कैन नॉट बी देयर, सिक्योरिटी ऑफ कंपनी विच इज हैविंग वोटिंग राइट्स, इंडेप्थनेस, ओके, और गारंटी टू। ओके, वी हैव डिस्कस कंपनी, होल्डिंग कंपनी, सब्सिडियरी कंपनी और एसोसिएट कंपनी और अदर सब्सिडियरी कंपनीज। ओके, बट वी हैव एग्जेम्पशन ऑफ 1 lakh, 5 lakh, 1 lakh। ओके, रिलेटिव, देन वी कैन, वी हैव डिस्कस पर्सन और पार्टनर कैन नॉट हैव डायरेक्ट और इनडायरेक्ट बिजनेस रिलेशनशिप विथ कंपनी, सब्सिडरी, होल्डिंग, एसोसिएट, अदर सब्सिडरी और सब्सिडरी ऑफ एसोसिएट। दिस वॉज द रिलेशन पॉइंट वी डिस्कस। आफ्टर दैट रिलेटिव कैन नॉट बिकम ए की मैनेजमेंट पर्सन और डायरेक्टर ऑफ ए कंपनी। ओके, देन सीलिंग लिमिट वॉज 20 कंपनी, ऑफेंसेज ऑफ फ्रॉड 10 years नॉट हैज बीन पास्ड अवे। And then we have discussed, you cannot give certain services to company, holding company, society company. And we have discussed total 8 services cannot be given. Okay. Section 144 services, that is called Section 144 services. Everybody clear, Malik? Okay. One of the question which I discussed yesterday, nobody, matlab wo point pe apan, we forgot out. Okay, so you have not answered that question. Can auditor become a director of subsidiary company? I'm asking एकदम सिंपल, doesn't वो कंपनीज एक्ट केस में कोई प्रॉब्लम? कंपनीज एक्ट ही तो मेरे को गवर्न कर रहा है ना। इफ आई एम डिस्कसिंग ए कंपनी विच इज गवर्न बाई कंपनीज एक्ट, ओके, कैन आई बिकम ए डायरेक्टर ऑफ ए कंपनी, ओके, सब्सिडरी कंपनी, ओके, एंड आई एम एन ऑडिटर ऑफ होल्डिंग कंपनी, और कैन आई बिकम ए डायरेक्टर ऑफ होल्डिंग कंपनी इफ आई एम एन ऑडिटर ऑफ सब्सिडरी कंपनी? ओके, ओके, लेट डिस्कस विद रिलेटिव। कैन रिलेटिव बी ए डायरेक्टर इन सब्सिडरी कंपनी? रिलेटिव, रिलेटिव, अरे क्या मजाक कर रहे हो यार बॉस। यस्टरडे डिस्कस, रिलेटिव शुड नॉट बी की मैनेजमेंट पर्सनल और डायरेक्टर ऑफ कंपनी। कैन यू बी की मैनेजमेंट पर्सन और डायरेक्टर ऑफ सब्सिडरी कंपनी? कैन यू बी एन होल्डिंग कंपनी? यस। कैन यू बी एन एसोसिएट कंपनी? यस। कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है, ही शुड नॉट बी इन कंपनी। नाउ माई क्वेश्चन कम्स, ऑडिटर, 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 CFS नहीं, CFS डोंट मर्ज CFS ना। स्टैट्यूटरी ऑडिटर समथिंग विद एन इंडिपेंडेंट ऑडिटर। वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट स्टैट्यूटरी ऑडिट रिक्वायरमेंट। ओके, मेक इट श्योर यू रिमेंबर दिस पॉइंट। ओके, 100%, 101% ऑडिटर कैन बिकम ए डायरेक्टर इन सब्सिडरी कंपनी इफ इज एन ऑडिटर ऑफ होल्डिंग कंपनी। ऑडिटर कैन बिकम ए डायरेक्टर ऑफ होल्डिंग कंपनी इफ इज एन ऑडिटर ऑफ सब्सिडरी कंपनी, नो प्रॉब्लम। ही शुड नॉट बी ए डायरेक्टर, ऑफिसर और एम्प्लॉय ऑफ द कंपनी। हाँ, सिक्योरिटीज शुड नॉट बी होल्डेड, इंडेप्थनेस शुड नॉट बी देयर, गारंटी शुड नॉट बी गिवन, दैट इज व्हाट वी डिस्कस, बिजनेस रिलेशनशिप शुड नॉट बी देयर। ओके, आर यू गेटिंग द पॉइंट? व्हेन वी आर डिस्कसिंग दिस पॉइंट, दिस स्ट्रक्चर यू नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड। ऑन बिजनेस रिलेशनशिप वी डिस्कस कमर्शियल रिलेशनशिप, ओके, कमर्शियल, हाँ, कमर्शियल, डोंट डिस्कस अबाउट डायरेक्टर। डायरेक्टरशिप कैन नॉट बी ए कमर्शियल रिलेशनशिप विच हैज बीन डिफाइंड। एम्प्लॉयमेंट टर्म्स रहेगा, एम्प्लॉयमेंट टर्म्स रह सकता है, नॉट एन प्रॉब्लम। ओके, ही कैन बिकम ए डायरेक्टर ऑफ सब्सिडी कंपनी, नो प्रॉब्लम, इफ इज एन ऑडिटर ऑफ holding company. If he is an auditor of holding company, can he become a director of holding company? No. And even in code of ethics, we'll discuss one thing, that you should not give the opinion where you are financially interested. And even in the scenario, if you are becoming a director, no issue, but you should not become a director of the company where you are an auditor. That's what we discuss. Okay, after that discussion, make it sure, a very important point, okay, just make it sure that come second point and third point, okay, he should not be an employee or officer of a company. Company, company. He can become an officer or employee of a subsidiary company, associate company, no problem. Holding company, no problem. Everybody clear, Malik? Okay. After that, we discuss about the particular point of basic concept with respect to appointment of auditor. Appointment of auditor, we discuss that first auditor, how he will be appointed. CAG, a government company, we discuss. CAG will be appointing the first auditor within 60 days. If he is unable to appoint, 30 days BOD and 60 days members. Okay, in normal cases, routine cases, in within 180 days from the commencement of financial years, CAG will appoint. And if there is a casual vacancy, okay, sir, CAG will appoint in 30 days, if not BOD in next 30 days. In other companies I discuss with you, other companies, which class of companies are there? So I discuss with you, 3 class of companies are there. Okay, public company, listed company, public unlisted companies, but their paid up share capital and borrowing should be focused on. And private company where paid up share capital and borrowing should be focused on. Private company where paid up share capital and borrowing is 50-50. Okay, and in public company listed, unlisted, okay, paid up share capital is 10 crore and borrowing is 50 crore. Okay, in that case, your first auditor will be appointed in 30 days and 90 days, okay, by members or board of director. Okay, whatever it may be, okay, in routine case, he will be director where the term will be defined. He will be selected in first AGM and he will be director till the conclusion of 6th AGM or 11th AGM as the case may be. Okay, and after that, if there is a casual vacancy, BOD will appoint the director in 30 days, but if there is a resignation case, he should take an approval of shareholder, okay, with the company appoint. Okay, after that we discuss with audit committee of provision, not a big deal for us, removal of auditor before the expiry of the term. I told you first prior approval of central government is required. After that, special resolution needed to be passed, and in that resolution, you should pass this thing that some other has been appointed or expressly you are not appointing that particular auditor. And this is before the expiry of term, 5 year ka term. Okay, in that scenario, I told you, okay, that if member need to remove that auditor, the 14 days before he need to give the notice, okay, and to the, before the AGM, and within 7 days before the AGM, that notice should be circulated between all the members, including auditor. An auditor should be given an opportunity of being heard, and he might represent in the AGM, okay, either in writing, which can be circulated with everyone, or it can be read orally. But if the aggrieved party, matlab the board of director or any person within the committee, okay, they find out that the particular written representation made by auditor is actually abusive. Okay, in that case, that particular thing cannot be read in the AGM, and this will be defined by tribunal. This will be decided by tribunal. And tribunal will define this one content which we need to remember. Okay, so we have discussed one more clause that tribunal on suo motu can remove the auditor before the expiry of term. Okay, the reason simple, tribunal either on its own or it can be with the, we receive the central government. Okay, they may identify that auditor has been acted, abetted or colluded in fraud. Okay, they may direct the company to remove the auditor before the expiry of term. In this case, if they receive the, okay, so from central government, they receive the intimation from central government, within 15 days need to pass the order to remove the auditor. Okay, the auditor removed will not be appointed as an auditor in any other company for 5 years. But I told you this 5 years is no way applicable because 10 years ka clause is there in disqualification. And last concept is that fine will be paid by firm and imprisonment will be done to the partner. After that we discuss, okay, is auditor remuneration TK not an issue? Okay, we discuss one of the important question again, power of auditor. Power of auditor we discussed total 5 power and 6 power was of CAG. First point, power is right to access. Okay, the right to access books of accounts and everything. Second power was I need to gather information and explanation from ME officer. Third point is right to have notice of AGM. AGM notice milni chahiye. Next is right to lien. But we have discussed right to lien, we required 4 conditions to be satisfied. Client owe you a money, you have got books of accounts not with irregular or illegal means. Third point, you have done some work and the amount which is pending or books of accounts which are there with you should be related to that work only. After that we discuss, you should have a right to report to the member true and fair. And last point is CAG will be having 3 powers. We discuss the 3 powers of CAG. First, appointment of first auditor and subsequent auditor. Second, CAG can ask for supplementary audit and CAG can ask for a test audit. Malikavadi clear? This is the content which you need to keep in mind with respect to this element. After this structure, we have discussed about the duties of auditor. When we are discussing about duties of auditor is discussed with respect to your first point. There are many duties I have been discussing. First point, inquiry on certain matters. When we are discussing about inquiry on certain matters, we have discussed 6 points. Okay, as auditor, you should inquire on loans and balances. Second, auditor, you should discuss on books entries. You should focus on sales of security. You should focus on loans and balances. Again, loans and advances again. After that, okay, you should focus on personal expenditure and last point, shares allocated for cash. Okay, we have discussed what need to be identified here, what kaise batana chahiye, kya nahi batana chahiye, that's it. After this, now please understand, there are few duties of auditor. What are the few duties of auditor? This is panchayati duty. Panchayati means a list of duties I'm going. And this is again section 143.1 only, that is continued here. Okay, auditor, your duty is to sign the audit report. Okay, you are required to sign the audit report. That's your duty. Okay, so yadagna, your right was, your power was, you need to report to member. But while reporting to member, make it sure your duty is to sign the audit report. Auditor, you should comply with SA. Comply with SA, okay, auditor, boss, if you don't comply with SA, you will be facing a big problem at your end, okay, and after that your concept comes into point, okay, auditor, now we are focusing on, okay, very important concept of auditor, that is your additional reporting. Help me out, first point was about, if you understood, the first point was about inquiry on matters, okay, in first point, auditor is not required to report unless until he does not see any unusual point. Example, if in case, okay, inquiry of loans and advances, if auditor identified they are properly secured, okay, he will not be disclosing in report. But the fourth point it is discussing, these are the matters which need to be reported in auditor report at the paragraph 10. And I told you, in realistic life, there is no concept of paragraph 10, there will be always annexures. And annexures will be added on. ICI given the annexures, annexures need to be added on with respect to this all element. So annexures rahega, annexures ke basis pe kaam hoga. Okay, now I'm discussing with additional reporting. Listen carefully, additional reporting kya hai? Okay, first point, okay, information and explanation should be received by auditor na? Okay, do you think the auditor is having a right to access the books of accounts? Yes. Okay. Is auditor having a right to get an information explanation from any officer of the company? Okay. That is your right, na? If you are not able to get any of the information from officer or employee, okay, you should mention in report. That is what your first point. If information and explanation is not available, okay, for the purpose of audit, you need to provide details of such information. Such information. Can anybody help me out when we discuss details of such information? This is nothing but, if you understood, limitation of scope. If you are asking a information and explanation, you are not getting limitation of scope. Sir, if we discussed yesterday, WR, do you remember WR? WR written representation. Help me out. Okay, can there be a management refusal to give WR? Okay, if management refused, we have discussed the points also. But if management refused and actually we identified that integrity of management is there, we will not perform procedure. I explain you why. Reason simple, you are getting WR at a last stage. You are not asking first only WR de do. WR is on last stage. So don't tell me you will perform procedures again. No, but definitely you will reevaluate the integrity of management. That there may be issue that he may give an a multiple WR and there may be a problems with that also. Okay, so here in that case you can modify the report. This is what 580 is saying na. So ultimately that's the scenario. You can give the explanation here, but modification may be done. It's your judgmental point because modification requires auditor judgment. Where material hai yaar, material raha toh auditor judgment aayega, judgment nahi hai toh there cannot be a concept of, matlab unless until materiality is not there, there is no concept of modification. That is your first point, okay, if you are not receiving information and explanation. Okay, B point, okay, whether books of accounts are properly maintained or not. Whether books of accounts are properly maintained or not. And for branch, I do think you are aware, on branch you sent the returns, properly returns have been submitted or not. Okay, so properly returns, okay, so on, okay, so branch may define certain period that every month or every quarter, okay, they can file returns from branch, okay, so all together kitna kya summary and that returns should be given to HO. Okay, so whether books of accounts are maintained and branch ke returns are have been properly received or not. Okay, if not, okay, so this need to be reported, nah, anyway, if they are maintained properly also, that also I need to report. Okay. पैरा 10 में, पर मैंने बताया पैरा 10 करके नहीं रहेगा, रियलिस्टिक में आप रियलिस्टिक बोलोगे तो पैरा 10 नहीं मिलेगा. इसका इंस्टीट्यूट ने एनेक्सर बनाया हुआ है. ओके, एनेक्सर मतलब एक डॉक्यूमेंट ही दिया हुआ है वेयर दे हैव रिटन ऑल दिस एलिमेंट्स ऑल दिस पॉइंट एंड यू नीड टू रिक्वायर डिफाइन दैट पॉइंट. ऑडिट रिपोर्ट में है ना मैडम, ऑडिट रिपोर्ट में पैरा नंबर 10 है ना, पर रियलिस्टिक में पैरा 10 में आपको मिलेगा अदर रिपोर्टिंग रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी रिफर एनेक्सर्स. तो एनेक्सर ऐड किए जाएंगे. ओके, दिस विल बहुत बड़ा कंटेंट रहेगा ये, ऐसा थोड़ा पूरा 10 फिर वो 10th पैराग्राफ नंबर ऑफ पेजेस में जाएगा, विच मे और मे नॉट बी रिलेवेंट फॉर मेनी शेयर होल्डर्स. हाँ हाँ, दैट्स योर सिनेरियो लाइक दैट. ओके, सेम सिनेरियो, सेम कॉन्सेप्ट है, लेकिन एनेक्सर आर बेस्ड ऑन कंपनीज एक्ट ओनली. अपना इंस्टीट्यूट का एनेक्सर है, ऑन वेबसाइट से दिस एनेक्सर इज अवेलेबल. सेम फॉर्मेट व्हाट वी आर डिस्कसिंग, दिस कॉपी पेस्ट, आई कॉपी पेस्ट फ्रॉम एनेक्सर ओनली. Okay, so unke annexure ke format mein they give and based on this annexure, I need to have annexure and last mein I should fill everything. Okay, so third point, iske saath mein books of account maintain kar rahe, nahi kar rahe, ye to ho gaya. Iske saath mein one more point is that branch audit report has been received or not. Okay, help me out, you are a HO ka auditor, you should receive branch audit report na? Okay, undoubtedly, okay, at 10 baje hum log dekhenge when we start 600. Okay, branch audit report should be received. Along with this point, okay, you need to understand whether balance sheet and P&L match with books of accounts. And if you remember, what does this mean? This means agreeing the financial statement with underlying records. Remember, Malik, agreeing the financial statement with the underlying records. Along with this point, you also focus on that whether balance sheet and PNL are in accordance with AFRF na? Yani in accordance with AS accounting standard. Malik, everybody clear? That's your books of accounts ka point. Okay, sir, any transaction which may have adverse effect, any transactions which may have adverse effect on company, transaction which may have adverse effect on company should be informed. Sir, can anybody give an example of transaction which may have adverse effect? We have discussed this transaction example many time. Okay, so going concern to, last issue ho gaya, but example, Satyam going for real estate business, it may have adverse impact on business na? It's a, again, will auditor, will you decide what business I should do? No. Okay, I will decide na. But you can report that it may have a adverse impact. It's your point. My vision is something different. I told you yesterday also when I was discussing about my brother. If my brother is an actual auditor of mine, he will always saying this is adverse effect, this is adverse effect, this is adverse effect. Okay, so logic ye hota bhai. So transaction which are having adverse effect. Okay, along with that point, you should also focus on, okay, director disqualification. In current year, if director is disqualified, okay, so auditor report, director disqualification should be reported by auditor. Okay, what we are discussing? Okay, the fourth additional reporting. Additional reporting by auditor. Additional reporting by auditor. This is an additional reporting which Companies Act is asking. Companies Act is saying, please report this also to shareholders. So we are discussing an additional reporting which Companies Act asks. As such, auditor report does not have. If you go with a framework standard, it does not have. Lekin, Companies Act is asking this point. When we go to CARO, okay, Company Act says to central government, if you want additional reporting, you ask. From my point of view, we ask in 143. So that is asked here. Okay, in CARO, that information is asked by central government. That's the difference you need to understand. So these are reporting which are asked by whom? Companies Act. Yes, sir. No, disqualification. If any disqualification is there, reporting is there. No other reporting. No director was disqualified in this year. Reporting need to be done. Okay, any director disqualified, you will be mentioning. If no director, then no director disqualified. What I am discussing was only the difference is in first point and fourth point. First point, you are required to do inquiry. And unless until there is no negative point, you will not report. But in fourth point, if it is whatever it may be, okay, you need to report. Director disqualified? No. Mention no director was disqualified in this year. Malik, everybody clear? Okay, along with director disqualification, we also need to remember, okay, one of the important aspect, okay, so if you remember IFC, what is IFC? Internal financial control. But I told you, as an auditor, you are not concerned with internal financial control. Okay, ICOF arna, lekin how the act is writing the content. IFC related to FR. Are you getting the point? This is the same content. Okay, but additionally in going on reporting, so internal financial control over financial reporting, whether they are effective or not, whether they are effective or not. If it is not effective, okay, so you are not required, you are required to report. If it, they are effective, you are required to report. In both the cases, you are required to report. Are Bharat Mata ki jai, understood kya re? Boss, but condition applied, and this was an amendment which has took place in last year. Okay, this concept is not applicable to OPC and small company. If you are reporting the auditor, if you are reporting for OPC and small company, you are not required to report on internal financial control. Okay, with reference to financial statement. Financial statement ke saath mein, whatever financial reporting nahi, financial statement. I missed out. Financial statement. Internal financial control with reference to, with respect to financial statement should not be reported for OPC or small company or any company, when we are discussing about small company can come into private companies also. Okay, but in small company, when we are discussing, okay, they have given the slab rate. Okay, such company should not have borrowing more than 25 crore. Okay, and such company should not have turnover more than 50 crore. Yani even a private company where borrowing is less than 25 crore, and whenever turnover is less than 50 crore, this concept is not applicable. Then if you are an auditor of private company, and private company mein if the turnover is less than kita 50 crore or borrowing is less than 25 crore. Okay, internal financial control or financial statement is not required to be mentioned. That's it. Again, I'm telling you, okay, you are not required to focus on operational controls. When I discuss only IFC, I may be worried about internal financial control which are related to operations also. Tumhare factories mein control kaise hai? Okay, factories mein controls kya hai? Child labor are appointed or not? That is a internal financial control, generic. Because at the end of the day, it will be having an indirect impact on going concern. Here they are saying only with reference to financial statements. That's it. You are not required to focus more in the scope. Okay. Example, okay, when you are discussing payment of salaries. Salaries ke liye, how the controls are working. So salaries ke liye, controls are operating effectively. Perfect. Okay, datas, how the datas are running? Controls operating effectively. Yes. So controls, how the controls? Yani logically you are reporting on TOC only. Okay, but TOC only for the financial statements related. But when we discuss in our audit procedure TOC, we are checking general TOC of the company. We never restricted ourselves to financial statement, because if we restrict ourselves to financial statement, kahin na kahin will be not identifying actual RMM of the company. And that is one of the critical element for any audit procedure. So that is what you need to understand. But this is a red point you need to take care of. Okay, that this particular reporting is not applicable to such companies. Baki all reporting is applicable to all companies. Okay, after that, one of the most important point, okay, is maintenance of books of accounts. Maintenance of books of accounts. Okay, maintenance of books of accounts. If they are not properly maintained, okay, or properly maintained, okay, whatever it may be, you need to report. Sir, okay, when we are discussing here in additional reporting B point, books of accounts are there or not there, and branch ka books of accounts are accessed or not. Okay, whether they are properly maintained or not, that is the next point. Books of accounts are in accordance with balance sheet and P&L is in accordance with books of accounts, that is your one point. Balance sheet and P&L is in accordance with accounting standard, that is your one more point. Okay, so logically, if you see here, okay, logically aap dekho idhar, okay, this is two content, this is one content, okay, and this is one content for books of accounts. So, ek hai, bhai auditor, books of accounts are properly maintained or not. Auditor, books of accounts are maintained properly or not. Balance sheet are in accordance with books of account, and balance sheet is in accordance with accounting standard. Are malik, everybody clear? That's what you need to understand with respect to this content. Ye content apne ko dhyan rakhna padta. Are Bharat Mata ki jai. Understood, malik? Okay, that is what your inquiry ka point, reporting ka point. And one of the most important point in reporting is your next, okay, second last point, and that is J point. Yes, buddy. One is, which one? Fifth is, as per AFRF. D point. Financial statements and books of accounts should match. Inventory, 1 crore. Trial balance, schedule 1 crore. Schedule say you will go to trial balance, 1 crore. Ledger, 1 crore. Okay. In ledger, when you did the valuation, whether you followed LIFO or FIFO, that is your next point. Financial statement completely match with this. Okay, this is your fourth point, D point. Completely, books of accounts and financial statement. Yes, year figure and year figure match. This is your fourth point. And fifth point, in this amount came from the valuation by LIFO or FIFO, whatever applicable, that is your fifth point. Okay, is Malik clear? Okay, and one more point they have given additionally, and this is what you need to understand. Okay, you need to focus on other matters, report on other matters also. Other matter, don't relate this other matter with, okay, 706. This is an additional other matter. But if you remember in 706, when I was discussing other matter also, I told you other matter is a part of other reporting responsibilities also. If nahi yaad hoga, you just can refer the notes. Okay, in other matter, I told you what can be the heading of other matter. Other matter, nahin, only other matter, nahin. Other matter or other reporting responsibilities. I made that point clear. Okay, yani it can be either paragraph number 5th or it can be paragraph number 10th. So this is something which is other matter only. Okay, but this will be a paragraph 10th wala concept.
This is not with reference to S706. This is reference to with Companies Act. So in other matter, they say, okay, auditor, you need to report, okay, all litigation and claims which are pending. Litigation claims which are pending. Okay, litigation and claims which are pending. Anyway, you will be reporting this because at the end of the day, this is also an EOM ka point. Because as an auditor, you need to understand EOM ka point, uncertainty, material uncertainties exist. Here, what is the difference between this and that then? There was only material uncertainty exist. Here you will be giving list of all litigation and claims. Are you getting the difference? When I was focusing on 706 EOM paragraph, emphasize of matter. In emphasis of matter paragraph, I've discussed the first point only. Yeah, the uncertainty. Okay, but that is material uncertainty. Any example, there may be three cases against me. One is 2 crore, one is 10,000, one is 12,000. Okay, in EOM, I'll mention only about 2 crore. Okay, here I'll mention all three cases against me. All pending litigation and claims against the company. Second point, okay, is one more important point. Okay, if that company has entered into derivative transaction and there is a material losses. Material losses is there for derivative transaction. Derivative transaction, material losses. Okay, if company has entered into material derivative transaction. And one more point, okay, if investor, I do think you are aware about investor and protection education fund. Investor protection education fund. Okay, investor education and protection fund. Okay, if there is a delay in transferring the amount, okay, you need to report. Okay, there was a delay or there was not a delay, doesn't matter. This is your 3 points which need to be reported. Once again, I'm discussing it out. First is litigation and claim. Second point, if your company is entering into derivative transaction and there is a material losses, material losses or material judgment. And third point, okay, the investor education and protection fund, if there is a delay in transferring any amount, and you are aware, okay, which amount are transferred. Matlab nahi malum to, aray example, dividends has been announced, but dividend after 7 years, nobody is taking the dividend. There will be amount will be transferred na? They transfer nahi kiya, so that need to be reported. I do think everybody clear, Malik? 2016 May, there was a bank note, specified bank notes, which has been defined, 500 ka notes and 1000 ka notes. Okay, this was an additional amendment in 2016 that how this company has dealt with specified bank notes, you need to report. Auditor, you calculate exactly on 8th of November, what was exactly bank note, how many bank notes were there, and by 30th of December, okay, how the bank notes are dealt off. Yani how, when they are deposited, what are the day, pura transaction, each and every, and that should be reported in the audit report. Right now, this will be very less relevance unless and until some audits are pending. Baki, other than that, now this point is not relevant in 2017 and 18 audit at all. So this concept is applicable only for which year audit? 16 and 17. So 16 and 17 ka audit no relevance rahega unless until that audit does not have reopening of accounts or re-verification of accounts. Unless until that concept does not comes, this will not be there. This is all your ink duties of auditor. Duties of auditor may one more duty is pending, that is of fraud. We'll discuss it out. But these are the duties of auditor. So duties of auditor, pura section 143 described on this page. Okay, so duties of auditor, first duty of auditor, you inquire on certain matters. The six matters they have defined. One is loans and advances, one is book entries, one is sales of security, one is loans and advances, one is personal expenditure, and one is share allocated for cash. Okay, the second point, the duty of auditor is to sign the audit report. The third point, duty of auditor is to comply with SA. Fourth point, okay, you need to perform additional reporting. Additional reporting, first reporting, you will perform information explanation which you have not received. Please mention. Okay, second point, you are responsible to ensure books of accounts are matching with the branch, maintained and matching with the branch, branch ka books of accounts, and branch ka books of accounts have, you have been received properly returns. Along with this point, the branch audit report has been received by you. Books of accounts are in accordance with balance sheet, and P&L is in accordance with books of accounts. Balance sheet P&L is in accordance with AFRF, matlab accounting standard. Any transaction which I have entered which is having an adverse effect. Okay, along with this, if there is a director who is disqualified, if there is an internal financial control over financial statements, and if you need to explain whether they are operating effectively, but this will not be applicable to OPC and small companies or the companies where paid up share, private company where paid up share capital and, sorry, paid up share capital, borrowings and turnover less than 50 crore, borrowing less than 25 crore. Okay. After that, you also report that maintain the books of accounts are properly done or not. And last point, you need to focus on other matters. And other matters will include, okay, sir, perfect, four matters. First matter is litigation and claim, all litigation and claim. Second point, you will be focusing on derivative transaction if there is a material losses. And if there is a delay in transferring in investor and projection, investor education and protection fund. And last concept is basically with respect to perfect. Okay, sir, specified bank notes during the period of 2016. Okay, sir, 8th November until 30th December. Okay, how they have built on? Yes, ma'am. Huh? Huh, third point. Investor education fund. It's a company who is responsible to transfer that amount to investor. Example, I announce a dividend. Okay, you have never claimed the dividend and that dividend amount is pending within my separate bank account. Okay, after still 7 years, it will become in that bank account. After 7 years, that will be transferred to investor education. 7 years has elapsed and that amount is still pending in my account only. I have not shifted that amount to investor protection and education fund. Education and protection fund. Okay, that this is delay, then I will mention here. Okay, this is what you need to understand. See, this is something which is called material fact. Material facts which you need to disclose. It may happen like we create the reserves, we create this particular point, we should not use for any personal purpose. Okay, example, debenture redemption reserve. Why I create a debenture redemption reserve? So that at the end of the day, I may redeem the debentures very easily. The amount can be transferred and amount can be allocated. Every year I transfer some amount. Now debenture redemption reserve fund I have created, and in that fund, now suppose there were 10 lakh rupees already there. Out of 10 lakh, right now my working capital is low. So what I did, I removed 8 lakh, which is, trustees aware of it. There is a trustee of debenture redemption fund. Trustees aware about it and I removed and I used for business and I transferred again. Wapas de diya. Balance sheet mein last day to 10 lakh se dikh raha na. Balance sheet mein to there is no change. 10 lakhs ka debenture redemption reserve fund is there, fund is there. But this is a material fact which need to be reported. Okay, this is a concept which you need to understand. So this is a part of material fact. I give one example, but this is something which you need to understand. They are discussing about all material fact which has been delayed. So material fact ke related, your discussion ho raha hai. That's it. Everybody clear? Okay, this is your duties of auditor. One of the important duty of auditor comes with your, I do think you are already, matlab ye apne discussion karte waqt dekha tha, duty to report fraud. And this is 143.12, if you remember. Okay, and duty to report fraud, there will be two cases. Okay, one case is amount is more than 1 crore and amount is less than, okay, or equal to 1 crore. It is 1 crore or less. Okay, everybody with me? Okay, let us assume the amount is more than 1 crore, okay, and amount is less than 1 crore. Okay, let's discuss like this. Okay, first, you are required to report CG. You are required to report central government. Everybody clear? Okay, along with this report to central government, okay, you should report to central government, okay, but how? What is the procedure? Immediately, but not later than 2 days, later than 2 days, immediately but not later than 2 days, the things should be reported to audit committee and board of directors. Immediately but not later than 2 days. Okay, within 45 days, within 45 days, within 45 days, within 45 days, okay, 45 days, okay, you should ask for reply. Once you receive the reply, okay, within 15 days, this reply should be submitted to whom? Central government. Okay, first of all, once you identify the fraud which is more than 1 crore, okay, you should inform immediately to Central Board of Director Audit Committee, but not later than 2 days. You should ask for reply within next 45 days. Okay, once you receive the reply, whenever you receive the reply, immediately within next 15 days, you should inform to CG, matlab MCA. Okay, it may happen that BOD or audit committee may not reply. Okay, So if BOD, an audit committee, okay, is BOD, an audit committee, not reply, does not reply, does not reply, okay, is at the end of 45 days, at the end of 45 days, now you need to inform CG again within 15 days. 15 days, inform CG. That, and you will, in this case, you will inform CG that the communication was done, but we have not received any responses. This is what your duties of auditor, statutory auditor. Okay, how you will inform to CG, Ministry of Company FSCO, how you will be sending? Okay, you will be sending a letter to secretary, okay, MCA, and this should be sent with RPAD. What is RPAD? Registered Post Acknowledgement Due. Registered Post Acknowledgement Due. One, I need to receive an acknowledgement. There should be in some written communication that by yaar haan maine bheja hua hai. Okay, registered post acknowledgement due or speed post. It can be anything. Speed post se bhejo yaar registered. Okay, post acknowledgement due. Okay, email confirmation is also okay for us. But there should be some acknowledgement with you that this had been done with this CG ka point. Everybody clear, Malik? And this need to be reported in form EDT-4 to central government. That's your procedure if there is a fraud which is more than, amount is more than 1 crore. But if amount is less than equal to 1 crore, what should be done? Okay, first of all, report to only 2%, BOD and Audit Committee. Sir, when should we report? Same, immediately, but not later than 2 days. Okay, what I should report? Okay, I should specify 3 things. First is nature of fraud. Okay, amount involved and parties involved in fraud. 3 things I need to inform. Nature of fraud, amount involved, parties involved in fraud. I do think everybody clear, Malik? And after that, BOD, board report should include, board report should include these all items plus, yani 3 item plus one more item, that what was remedial action is taken. Remedial action taken by board. Malik, everybody clear? That these things are not required to be sent to CG or something less than 1 crore may. Malik, everybody clear? If auditor is not able to comply section 143.12, okay, he will be attract a penalty of minimum 1 lakh and maximum 25 lakhs. 1 lakh se likar kitna amount ho sakta hai? 25 lakh. I am again telling you, this is what I am discussing for non-compliance with section 143.12. If auditor is involved in fraud, the case is different. If auditor was involved in fraud, the case is different, and we will discuss in liability of auditor. Probably mera aaj wo karo nahi chalu ga starting mein, so I may discuss liability of auditor in next half an hour. Matlab wo fir auditor, liability of auditor, I will discuss it out, complete. Okay, so, kyunki this will be taking more 15-20 minutes with respect to this content. Matlab ye hone ke baad. Okay, so in liability of auditor, you will come to know that if you are involved in public fraud, boss, it's a very, one of the way worst issue. This is for non-compliance of 143.12. Okay, you are not involved in fraud, but committee, managing committee or some employees or officers of the company, they were involved in fraud, and how they are handling, that is what we discuss here. Bharat Mata ki Jai. Understood, Malik? If the amount is less than 1 crore, okay, you are not required to go to central government. You are required to inform audit committee and board of director immediately, but not later than 2 days. When you are informing to audit committee or board of director, you should specify 3 things. Okay, what was the nature of fraud, amount involved, and who are the parties involved. Okay, and board, in their board report will be prepared. Okay, and board report mein they will mention, okay, these 3 things along with one more thing, remedial action taken. Yani in board report rahega, board meeting hoega, board report banega, board report mein wo log ye 4 cheeze mention karenge. What are the 4 things they will mention? Okay, what are the nature of fraud, amount, parties, and remedial action taken by them. Malik, everybody clear? Are yes or no? That's a content to be focused on with respect to duty to report fraud. This is your section 143.12. Huh? Board ki liability. Apan auditor padh rahe na, board thoda padh rahe madam. Okay, jab law mein padhoge to director ki responsibility aayegi. Director is penalized here. अगर उन्होंने नहीं किया तो इट मींस कि दे आर इन्वॉल्व इन फ्रॉड ना, ऑडिटर की रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी वेर इट एंड्स, बस इन्फॉर्म. अब बोर्ड ने नहीं किया, बोर्ड का रिपोर्ट इज नॉट ओनली डायरेक्टर इज नॉट द यूजर ऑफ द ऑडिटर इज नॉट द यूजर ऑफ बोर्ड रिपोर्ट ना, तो ऑडिटर बस ऑडिटर ने ये देखना कि ये नहीं हुआ, अभी नहीं हुआ तो डायरेक्टर यू आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल, तो डायरेक्टर की रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी शिफ्ट टू डायरेक्टर, ऑडिटर का नहीं. ऑडिटर ने अपना काम कर लिया ना भाई, बस उसके पास वो रिटर्न कम्युनिकेशन शुड बी देयर दैट यार ये हुआ है कि नहीं. अभी आप बोलोगे सर फिर बोर्ड का क्या, फिर हुआ तो अपने को लॉ में पढ़ना पड़ता है कि बोर्ड नहीं किया तो क्या करेगा. मालिक एवरी क्लियर एंड ऑफ दैट फॉर्म एडीटी फोर, फॉर्म एडीटी फोर, एडीटी फोर, एडीटी इज एन ऑडिटर्स फॉर्म. ओके सारे ऑडिट के फॉर्म्स है, वो फॉर्म की लिस्ट है. तो वाइल सबमिटिंग टू सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट विल बी सबमिटिंग दिस डिटेल इन एडीटी फोर, फॉर्म नंबर एडीटी फोर कर गया. मालिक एवरी क्लियर. सो ड्यूटीज ऑफ ऑडिटर अगर देखोगे तो यू विल कम टू नो देयर आर टोटल व्हाट वी डिस्कस वाज फाइव मेन कॉन्सेप्ट. फर्स्ट वाज इंक्वायरी, सेकंड वाज साइन, थर्ड वाज कंप्लाई विद एसए, एडिशनल रिपोर्टिंग एंड फ्रॉड. आई थिंक एवरी क्लियर. एंड एडिशनल रिपोर्टिंग मल्टीपल पॉइंट्स वर देयर. ओके एंड इन मल्टीपल पॉइंट्स वी डिस्कस इन लास्ट पॉइंट आल्सो देयर वर फोर पॉइंट्स. दिस हाउ द आंसर हैज बीन ड्राफ्टेड. Complete answer for duties of auditor is next to impossible. It may happen, they may ask only for inquiry matters, or they may ask for reporting, additional reporting matters, or they may ask for fraud ka matter. But I told you, if fraud ka question come na, they will not be asking this only answer. They will be asking this answer along with 240 ka answer, which I will discuss as a combined answer later on. Malik, everybody clear? That's what your structure to be focused on with respect to this concept. So any doubt till here, Malik? Paka? That's your duties and powers and duties of auditor. That's your sector with powers and duties of auditor, Malik. So logically, now we are discussing some punchet points. Okay, one is about books of accounts. Okay, one is about financial statements. Okay, these are section, these are part additional point which we are discussing it out. Just remember karlo. Sun lo, matlab just listen it, because again it's an IPCC. I doubt once wapas it will be coming in your final, but it's only just reading that one content once. Okay. One is about BOA, books of accounts, and one is about FS, financial statement. This has nothing to do with LDR. This is very least important concept of your syllabus. Okay, books of account. First of all, when I say books of accounts include, okay, so what it includes? Cash book, it include trading account, it include, okay, the balance sheet, it include cost records. These are nothing but books of accounts. When we discuss about this concept of books of accounts, we need to understand, okay, when you can say that books of accounts are proper books of accounts are there, first of all, the books of accounts should be true and fair. How to be true and fair? As per AFRF and fair presentation, as per the format which is prescribed by law and regulation. So true and fair hona chahiye. Okay, double entry system is required. Double entry system ke basis pe hona chahiye. Double entry system, and when we are discussing accrual basis, okay, so this is proper books of account. Okay, basic point. Okay, along with books of accounts, where to keep books of accounts? We are already aware where to keep books of accounts. Registered office, registered place of business, books of accounts should be kept. Can we keep these books of accounts on any other place in India? Any other place in India, you can shift this in India only, huh? India. Okay, but here what you need to understand, BOD resolution is required, and this resolution within 7 days I need to submit to whom? ROC. I need to inform to ROC about the new address. If you remember yesterday we discussed that auditor, if you want a right to lien, it should not be regular or illegal. Yani it means when you are taking the books of accounts, you need to tell BOD that I am taking a books of account because you are not paying the fees. Okay. Yani board will pass the resolution. Yes, auditor is taking because we are not paying the fees. And after that they will be telling ROC that 7 days my books of accounts have been shifted to auditor place. Are you getting the point? This is actually a very point. मतलब अगर पैसा ही नहीं दे रहा तो वो कैसा देगा आगे? Okay, that is what your scenario with 33rd point. Okay, याद रखना, registered office पे रहना चाहिए books of accounts. हाँ? ROC. दोनों मतलब wherever the registration has been done, वो registration जिधर किया हुआ ना उसके पास. Okay, that's a scenario. तो जहां पर भी रजिस्ट्रेशन प्रोसेस बीन डन ना उसके हिसाब से रहेगा. बट वन वी आर फोकसिंग ऑन दैट ना, अभी तक ओल्ड आरओसी में ही एवरीथिंग इज डन. मतलब नाउ मैक्सिमम टास्क इज विद रिस्पेक्ट टू रजिस्टर्ड ऑफिस एंड अदर थिंग्स ना, इट इज टेकन केयर बाय ओनली दैट पॉइंट, दैट स्ट्रक्चर. ओके, ब्रांच बुक्स ऑफ अकाउंट्स, वेयर इट विल बी केप्ट? ब्रांच बुक्स ऑफ अकाउंट्स इट विल बी केप्ट इन ब्रांच ओनली. ओके, बट फ्रॉम ब्रांच यू शुड रिसीव, ओके, प्रॉपरली समराइज रिटर्न्स. Summarized returns. It will not be kept at HOA. At summarized returns, okay, at regular interval to HO. Okay. When we are discussing about books of accounts, one of the most important, how many year books of accounts should be maintained? If it is less than 8 year, okay. If it is less than 8 year, all the years. If it is more than 8 years, only 8 years. If it is more than 8 years, an investigation is going on. Investigation for the period which investigation is going on, that periods. Okay, yani if it is less than 8 years, all the years need to keep. All the years. Matlab example, 5 years you have been incorporated, all 5 years. Okay, 6 years you are incorporated, all 6 years. Okay, but it is more than 8 years. Okay, example, you have 10 years, so you'll be keeping only for 8 years. Last 2 years, crap. But if investigation is going on, an investigation is of a matter of something which is more than 8 years, yani example, 10th year ka investigation chal raha hai, last 10 years ka investigation chal raha hai, you need to keep the books of account. Now you can't tell that law is saying that more than 8 years, I'll be keeping only for 8 years. Investigation hai, till all the period of investigation, you need to keep the books of accounts. Example, right now, if your investigation is going on for 3 and 4 का इन्वेस्टिगेशन चल रहा है, अभी तक चल रहा है, मतलब केस इज गोइंग ऑन एंड असेसमेंट इज गोइंग ऑन एंड एवरीथिंग. ओके, अज्यूम करो 3 and 3-4 का इन्वेस्टिगेशन चल रहा है. ओके, देन नाउ राइट नाउ इट इज ऑलमोस्ट 15 years. ओके, तो नाउ आई मे नॉट डिबेट दैट आई बी नॉट कीपिंग बुक्स ऑफ अकाउंट्स ओनली, आई विल बी कीपिंग 8 years, आई विल बी डिलीटिंग बुक्स ऑफ अकाउंट. ऐसा नहीं होगा, बिकॉज नाउ इट इज वी आर कीपिंग बुक्स ऑफ अकाउंट एनी वे इन इलेक्ट्रॉनिक फॉर्मेट, बट वी विल बी कीपिंग दैट बुक्स ऑफ अकाउंट फॉर ऑल द ईयर्स वेयर इन्वेस्टिगेशन इज टेकिंग प्लेस. So all the years where investigation is taking place, investigation ka period should be defined. Malik, everybody clear? Okay. Along with this point, okay, who is able to inspect the books of accounts? It's a director who can inspect the books of accounts, but during office hours. Office hours. Subsidiary books of accounts can be inspected by the person appointed by a director. Okay, BOD, they will be appointing a and by passing a board resolution. The subsidiary ka books of accounts can be inspected by a person, okay, who is appointed by board by passing a board resolution. Subsidiary ka books of account, director will not, may probably director inspect, director may inspect in during the office hour, but in case of subsidiary, there can be any other person also, which may be appointed by BOD. Okay, along with this point, there is one more element. Okay, nowadays you need to understand, you don't maintain, okay, the hard copy of books of account, you maintain electronic books of accounts. And if it is electronic books of accounts, Malik, first point, okay, you need to understand that server should be in India. Server should not be outside India. The second point, okay, this particular, it should be in format which was originally generated. Format should not be modified. Server should be in India. Format should be original. Okay, it should be in legible format. Okay, which is required by law and regulation. Legitimate hona zaruri hai. Okay, books, branch ke books, electronic books should not be altered. See, in electronic form, okay, example, in tally, you'll be getting 001, 002, 003. Okay, so you put into your system, you should not alter that books of accounts. Okay, when we are discussing, it should not be altered 100%. You should also keep one more thing, backup should be always available. And all about this thing should be informed to ROC. ROC ko kya inform karna padega? Who is the service provider? Okay, what is a IP address where the books of accounts are maintained? Okay, location. Okay, or when it is focusing on cloud, whether it is kept on cloud, you are not having your own server and you are keeping the books of accounts on cloud. Example, if you are having your own server, now this is something about ISCA. Okay, so you study in ISCA, okay, so IT, okay, so cloud can be private cloud or public cloud. If it is a private cloud, it means my own server, and if it is public cloud, it means the server is of somebody else. Okay, where everybody is keeping. If I am keeping on public cloud, I need to inform RSC. If it is a private cloud, then I need to give the detail of service provider, okay, internet protocol address, I need to give the location of that server, that's it. Okay, that's what your scenario with respect to this point. This is what your company Jack, okay, for books of account is there. Books of accounts majorly, okay, nothing to do with respect to this point, it's only because that content is there, part and parcel of Companies Act, I'm continuing. Okay, so ek bar main just fatafat refresh maro books of account. Books of account should first point, books of account includes cash book, trading account, balance sheet and cost records. Proper books of account should be true and fair, double entry system, accrual basis. Registered place will be your, okay, the books of accounts where it is kept. If you are keeping it some other place, board resolution should be passed and within 7 days ROC should be given a notice. Okay, matlab informed intimation to be given to ROC. Branch books of accounts will be kept at branch, but summarized returns will be given to HO at regular intervals. Retention period for books of account should be 8 years. Okay, if it is less than 8 years, all the years. If it is more than 8 years, only 8 years for investigation period, for all the period of investigation. Okay, after that, okay, the inspection can be done by director during the office hour. Subsidiary books of accounts can be inspected by a person who is appointed by board by passing a board resolution. If it is an electronic form of books of accounts, okay, we need to ensure that first of all, server should be in India. Second, it should be in specific same format which was originally generated. It should be in legitimate format. Okay, the branch books of accounts should not be altered. And okay, you should ensure that books of accounts, when we are focusing on, okay, it is taking care of, backup is taken care of. And all this thing, okay, need to inform to ROC along with who is the service provider, who is the internet, what is an internet protocol address, what is the location, and if it is on cloud. Cloud means which cloud? Public. Okay, the example Dropbox, Google Drive. Google Drive is not your own point. So if you are keeping books of accounts on Google Drive, so then you need to inform that the books of accounts are available on Google Drive. Whatever link and other things will be there will be informed. Undoubtedly, to access that link, passwords and other things will be there at your end, controls will be there, but these things need to be intimated to ROC. Okay, so when we discuss books of accounts, okay, but financial statements stands to be very critical. Okay, so, matlab, again, not important from your examination point of view, but it's only a point. Okay, so financial statement, first scenario is that it should be true and fair. And when it will be true and fair, beta, when it is complying with AFRFNE, accounting standard and schedule 3. Whichever accounting standard is determining, okay, so companies ke liye na we are discussing, the company may follow Indian accounting standard also or accounting standard also. Okay, the second scenario, okay, so yaad rakhna, but this is not applicable to, we have discussed, if you remember, banking, insurance, electricity. This already we discussed during 700. Okay, so in when we are discussing about this point, we have discussed this point. Okay, so financial statement should be laid down in AGM. Okay, who will be laying down this in AGM? It is board. Okay, CFS of company should be prepared in the same form as its of own form. If any company is having one or more subsidiaries, if any company is having one or more subsidiaries or associates or joint venture, okay, that company should prepare CFS in the form or in the manner in which their own financial statements were prepared. And this we discussed during CFS also. But we have discussed exemptions are available. No. Harmonization is my responsibility. I am telling exemptions are available. So what are the three conditions for exemption? First point, I am myself a subsidiary of some company and I have given everyone in writing that I will not prepare CFS. Second, I am not listed, not in the process of listing. And third, my intermediate or, okay, the ultimate holding company is filing, okay, the CFS with ROC in the same accounting policies, same accounting policies with respect to, you need to understand that was actually interpretation issue I told you also. Okay, I think everybody clear, Malik? Okay, that's what a scenario you need to understand with CFS. The CFS, ye log bolte hai ki bhai comply karna chahiye, CFS ka point you need to ensure. And if you need to understand, if we have discussed, can there be a scenario when I don't comply with AS? If I don't comply with AS, okay, what should be done? Deviation batao, what is the deviation? Along with deviation, reason batao, why you did deviation, usko batao, and last, what is an effect because of the deviation? So three things you will be ensuring, and this will be entered, okay, in your, okay, the financial statements, financial statements, you need to disclose this in notes to accounts. Why this policy is not in accordance with accounting standard? Okay, how much is the deviation? What is the deviation actually? You need to explain that. What is the reason why you are focusing on this deviation? And what is the actual effect of the deviation? And if I follow accounting standard, okay, and if I am following this fund, okay, what is an actual amount of differences which we are focusing on? Malik, everybody clear? So again, financial statements, not a big deal. Now coming very important section of your, okay, which is actually modified by Companies Act 2013. One is section 131 and 130, 130 and 131, very important section to understand. And how it is relevant now, that you will come to know only at the today's end of the lecture. Okay, many times now after reading this section 130 and 131, you will be coming in mind, maa kasam sala aisa kaisa ho sakta hai, or why it will be done. Okay, so today end of the day we'll discuss that one. Matlab end of the day we need, dufer ko before the Howrah gravy starts. Matlab our food and other things, Howrah, matlab go for eat lunch and other things. Before only we'll be getting that clarity. But nevertheless, what is 130 and 131? The first I'm discussing 131 and then I'm discussing 130. Okay, 131 is about voluntary revision of FS. Voluntary revision of FS. Voluntary revision of financial statement. Voluntary revision of financial statement. Once again, now. Voluntary revision of financial statement. Voluntary revision of financial statement. When I'm discussing voluntary revision of financial statement, understand, director of a company, okay, can voluntarily revise FS or board report. Director responsibility statement. Board report. Mera board report jo rahega, I may revise that because I submit annual reports, may I also submit my board report. Director responsibility statement, my responsibility for that. Yes. Financial statement is part nahi hai. It is a part of annual reports, which I submit with ROC also. It's a part of annual report. Mera annual report mein board report rahega. They say nahi ka, from the desk of the board. Mala what they are saying, how they are commenting. Okay. A boss example in what director responsibility statement is the next one only, that we have complied with accounting standard, we have taken care of going concern. We have ensured that all things are taken care of. Okay, we have detected fraud, we are having a good controls, compliance of policies and procedures. That's it. That's fine. So we have mentioned that in board report. Okay. So financial statement, board report. I can revise. Who am I? Who am I? Director. Yaad rakhna ek ek cheez. I will discuss in afternoon. Director can revise voluntarily. Okay. If they do not comply with section 129 or 134, what is 129? 2 minutes back we discussed was 129. Malik, everybody clear? Okay, if this is a scenario, if anything which is not complied with this, okay, I may revise voluntarily my financial statement, which are already submitted to ROCA. Okay, which are already submitted to ROCA, Malik. Okay, or 134, 5 minutes ke baad dikhte hai. 134 is nothing but director responsibility statement. Malik, everybody clear? Okay, that's what you need to understand with section 129 and 134. Everybody clear, na Malik? Okay, so if I don't comply, if my financial statements are not complying with 129 and 134, okay, so I can revise financial statement. The financial statement can be revised of any three preceding years. Any three preceding years, huh? Preceding years may any of the year which you need to take. Example, last year, and last to last year. Out of 3 years, whichever year you need to revise financial statement, you can revise. Okay, and you need to understand before you revise, you require a tribunal approval. Okay, tribunal approval ke bina, okay, you cannot focus on revision of financial statement. And along with this point, tribunal approval, you need to submit copy of tribunal order, okay, with ROC. Sir, can there be instance that I submitted financial statement with ROC, I filed my annual report with ROC 2 years back, last year also I submitted, and today I am revising that financial statements? And I'm saying that there was some misstatement, whether there was some point or something. Can it happen? See, we are not going in income tax. You don't enter in income tax. Income tax ka discussion nahi ho raha hai. So don't consider in income tax revised returns, what should be done in income tax, that will be income tax law itself. Yaha par we are discussing the annual report which are submitted to ROCE. The annual report which are submitted to shareholders. The financial statements which are given to shareholders already 2 years back. Can I revise that? That is power given in 131. Are you getting the point? So 131. Why in afternoon 2 o'clock? Is that clear? Instances hai. Afternoon 2 o'clock we'll discuss. Aisa kyun ho sakta hai sir? Okay, sir. 2 saal ke baad unko aisa malum pada ke 2 saal pehle ka kuch issues tha. And that need to be taken care of. Okay, this can be amended. I do think everybody clear, Malik? We'll discuss it out. Wapas bol raha ho. 131 is voluntary revision. Voluntary revision. Okay, and 130 will be compulsory. Karna hi padega. Koi bahar wale nahi bola. 131, director himself want to revise financial statement. Okay, and if he need to revise the financial statement, he will be definitely opening the books of accounts. Okay, and when he revise financial statement or he need to revise the board report, director responsibility statement. Okay, if he need to revise that, because if it is not in compliance with section point, okay, he can revise along with books of accounts, whatever it may be, just to match chemically, whatever he need to do. But when we discuss about 130, it is a reopening of accounts. Reopening of accounts. Yani what may happen here? Reopening of accounts kya hota hai? Okay, here now we have multiple points. CG, central government, SEBI, income tax authority, okay, the statutory body or any authority or any person concerned. Okay. And along with order made by court or tribunal can reopen the accounts if the accounts were maintained in a fraudulent manner, if accounts were maintained in fraudulent manner or mismanaged, if accounts were maintained in fraudulent manner or mismanage, they can reopen the accounts. Okay, so this reopening the accounts ke liye, company should receive the notice. Without notice, company will never reopen the account. And notice is received on the pace of by court or tribunal. Koi mujhe samjha ka reopening of the account matlab kya? What does reopening of account is? Changes to account, ठीक है बाद में this section came only in last 2 years back. Why this section was inserted? What is the reason? We need to मतलब important point है वो बहुत जरूरी है. Why reopening of the account is done? That is the reason, man. I understood. What is meaning of reopening of accounts? मैं question ये पूछ रहा हूँ. I understood that okay, financial statements or books of accounts were prepared in fraudulent manner or mismanaged. So central government, SEBI, income tax, okay, so statutory body or any person who is concerned along with order of court or tribunal can reopen my account. What is meaning reopen of account of Amit Athreda? Let us assume. Huh? Start ka we'll discuss how many years. Okay, so I'm not discussing out how many years, but what is meaning of reopening of account? Example, okay, so if you are reopening Amit Athreda account, what does it mean? मैं example मतलब समझना चाहता हूँ उसका. See, financial statement मतलब क्या है? Financial statement means, okay, so, I'm revising some figures. I may revise the figures which is not in accordance with accounting standard. I'm modifying in accordance with accounting standard. Initially, I thought, can there be a deviation with accounting standard? Okay, there was a deviation, 2 years there was a deviation, but after 2.5 years, I understood that deviation is not having an impact on me. I am redesigning my accounting policy, and from 3 years back, what I am doing, I am changing my accounting policy 3 years back, and I am revising that accounting policy only for inventory. Okay, and inventory ka now I changed, and now I brought this accounting policy. So what I did, I voluntary revise, because that was not in accordance, I thought it is not in accordance with this section. But you need to understand, na? Okay, it's voluntary revision. Matlab, wo maine likha nahi hai. It is taken only once in a year. Okay, वन टाइम नहीं, थ्री इयर्स का प्रीसीडिंग पीरियड कर सकते हैं लेकिन एक ही बार कर सकते एक साल में. अंडरस्टैंड हाउ मेनी इयर्स आई कैन रिवाइज पास थ्री इयर्स बट दैट कैन बी डन ओनली वंस इन ए ईयर. हाँ मतलब इफ आई रिवाइज राइट नाउ, इफ आई से आई वॉन्ट टू रिवाइज राइट नाउ, इफ आई सबमिटेड ऑर्डर आई गो वेंट टू ट्रिब्यूनल एंड आई एम रिवाइजिंग राइट नाउ इट इज 1819, इफ आई एम रिवाइजिंग 1617, I'm not revising 1780. I'm revising only 1617. Okay, then after 2 months, I'm saying I want to revise 1718. Not possible. 1 year should be lapsed. After 1 year, I can revise 1718. One time I can revise all three. Are you getting the point? Okay, nahi samjha. Okay, revision ka power can be done only once in a year. Once in a year, the revision can be done for how many years? 3 years. This is the point you need to understand. It may happen the revision you may do only in 1 year. You may not require to do revision in 2 years. But that power can be taken only once in a year. Financial year jo rahega, one time that financial year April to March, you can take only one time that revision. After that one more time you need to do the revision. It will not be possible unless until year lapse. नहीं नहीं 15 16 16 17 17 18. यस प्रेजेंट थ्री ईयर दे आर वॉलंटरी ना, इट हैपेंस. दैट्स ओनली आई एम टेलिंग यू ना, यू आर नॉट अवेयर ऑफ द इंस्टेंसेस. यही तो हो रहा है ना, सत्यम के केस के बाद ये मेन कॉन्सेप्ट आया हुआ है सत्यम, बिकॉज दैट इज वन ऑफ द इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट. व्हाट हैपेंड अर्लियर फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट विच वर इश्यूड टू एवरीवन वर एक्चुअली फॉर्ज्ड. ओके इफ कंपनी अंडरस्टूड, ओके देयर मे बी हैपन दैट फ्रॉड केस वॉज देयर बट देर वॉज नो कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ फ्रॉड. मैनेजमेंट वॉज नॉट, देर वॉज नो इश्यू विथ इंटीग्रिटी ऑफ मैनेजमेंट. मैनेजमेंट वॉज नॉट अवेयर ओनली दिस वुड बी एन इंपैक्ट इन 2 years डाउन द लाइन. And later on they identified, okay, they identified and they modified the financial statement. But after again, next year, they revise this thing. Okay, they are having that power. They can be doing that one revision. But revision should restrict itself to last 3 years. Example, suppose what he told right now, if I do revision in 15, 16, 16, 17, 17, 18. Now again in next year, can I revise 16, 17? Yes, but I cannot revise 15, 16. So if there is a misstatement there, or mismatch there, then you will be held, मतलब वो problematic issue होएगा, because at the end of the day, investigation can be done for 8 years. So when you are dividing, see, understand, revision does not give you power that you can do anything, but revision should be in a careful revision, because when you revise the things, 101% investigation will start. 101%. Are you getting the point? And that's what you need to understand with respect to the revision. Malik, are you samjha kya? Artham aindiya? Nahi. Did you understood? But revision can be done once in a? Nahi, once in 3 years nahi madam. Once in a year for 3 years. Okay. Reopening of account, which I was asking you, was basically what it means. It means CG, SEBI or anything, they can go to court or they can go to tribunal and they ask to reopen the account. It means they can do or perform the re-audit again, because and that can be done only if there is a fraudulent or mismanaged. Example, later on they identified that whatever sales was disclosed or whatever salary was disclosed, it was dummy salary, or whatever payment was done as a professional fees, there was no concept of professional fees. They came to know in this year that professional fees ka fraud over there. Now don't you think if this year this is a scenario, can it happen in last earlier year also? Okay, concerned person may raise the request to tribunal and court that this happened, professional fees was forged. Example, I gave you, if you remember, okay, Karthik is having in cash. I am having white money. I want to reduce my tax liability. My tax liability is coming 30 plus because plus surcharge. I will be in 10 lakhs, I will be paying 3.5 lakhs. Okay, based on surcharge. So what should I do? Okay, Karthik is having black money. Black money kaha se aaya Karthik ke paas? Through the rotation. Okay, he generated, he didn't pay tax, but he wanted white money ka concept. So what I will do, I will arrange the concept with Karthik, and Karthik ko main 10 lakhs dunga minus 1 lakh TDS. Okay, what 9 lakhs I will pay to Karthik. Karthik will give cash 9 lakhs. For me, it is a saving of 2.5 lakhs. Rather than I am giving to the government, I am saving in a, okay, and for Karthik, all black is becoming white, and the source is very definite. In the black source kya batata tha wo? Source would be a very problematic issue. And this happens when it comes to this point. So ye structure hota hai, and in due course, in current year, if you identified this is happening, so it may happen in earlier years also na? Reopening may happen. But make sure reopening can be made. Okay, it's for how many years? Huh? 8 years. It can be made for 8 years. How many years you are keeping books accounts? 8 years. Or if there is an investigation going on, okay, then it can be for more than 8 years. Are you getting the point? Yani reopening, okay, is not to be made, not to be made, not to be made beyond 8 years. Not to be made beyond 8 years. Did you understand this concept? Okay, unless and until. America, you understood? Okay, is reopening not to be made beyond 8 years unless and until, okay, is government has order to keep the books, order to keep the books of accounts for more than 8 years. I do think you understood. Samjhata good enough nahi to chhod do jaane do. But this is very simplified version. Matlab logic hai yaar, ekdam simple hai. Reopening can be done only for the last 8 years. Okay, so unless and until, okay, so if it is government has already given a notice, matlab to keep the books of account for more than 8 years, then definitely for more than 8 years. This is your reopening and this one is revision. So 130, 131. I do think everything clear. 130 is about reopening, 131 is revision. Which is voluntary? 131, revision. Which is compulsory? 130. Okay, so 130, outsider come into picture. 131, insider come into picture. No, no, it's not a revision of books. It's inquiry of books, inquiry of fraud. Why reopening happen na? Wohi main bol raha hu. Ye dono QI, what the reason? मतलब वो आपको स्टैंडर्ड समझने के बाद आएगा. वंस यू अंडरस्टैंड, मतलब आइदर यू स्टडी दैट फर्स्ट एंड देन यू स्टडी दिस, और नाउ यू स्टडी दिस, तो यू बाय अंडरस्टैंडिंग नाउ यू विल क्लियर विद द स्टैंडर्ड व्हाट यू विल डू. तो एट 2 o'clock आई विल आस्क यू व्हाट यू विल डू नाउ, देन यू शुड आंसर, हाँ सर आई विल डू लाइक दिस, आई विल डू रीओपनिंग, आई विल डू रिविजन. दैट शुड बी योर आंसर नाउ. दैट्स अ क्लिक. ये भारत माता की जय. अंडरस्टूड कह रहे एवरीबडी? रिविजन कैन बी डन फॉर हाउ मेनी इयर्स? Revision 3 years only. It cannot be possible for 8 years. 3 years, past 3 years. Once in a year for past 3 years. Okay, so reopening? 8 years unless until government has not ordered. Malik, everybody clear? Okay, so reopening will be done by outsiders. Revision is done by insider. Make it sure ye dimag mein rahe. Everybody clear? Okay, sir. Pakka, did you understood na reopening and revision? Okay, so reopening is done only when there is a case of fraudulent. See, logic. When director will revise, when they are aware there was a mistake by them. If they are aware there was a fraud by them only, they will keep silent. Remember? If they are aware they have done the fraud, why they will revise? Okay, they will never revise, because you need to understand, after revision also, it is not so they will only inform a ROC. They need to inform each and every shareholder. Public notice need to be given. Newspaper made notice need to be given to everyone that this has been revised. Earlier financial statement, if you rely on that one, okay, you need to rely on your. Tell me, don't you think it will impact the share market also? So the revision is not very easy. It is a very sensitive decision for the directors also. Arre boss, pura share market bhi hil sakta hai. Okay, so imagine if there is a revision, because of revision, the profit figures and other things have dramatically impacted. Okay, so what will happen then? Who is responsible for that? Ye sari cheeze impact hogi, and it may have impact on the current financial statements, and because of current financial statement the things may sablu work out, and next day share market may khatam, tera pura company ka vaat lag sakta hai. So what, matlab somebody has asked question, if I revise now, okay, you ask a question, revise now, and next year again I revise, this is not so easy task. We are discussing very easily because we are thinking revision is very easy, because the answer is very easy. Okay, but you need to understand, in realistic, imagine telling to ROC that I need to revise, and next year again coming telling to ROC I need to revise. This is the scenario, and you need to directly not to go to ROC, you are going to tribunal first, NCLT. Okay, how you handle this all things, and this is very sensitive part, Malik. Everybody clear? Okay, when revision can be done? If your books of accounts, if your financial statements are not in accordance with 129 and 134. Okay, so 134 is your next section, second last point. Director responsibility statement, section 134. Okay, very easy, very small point. Tamarind rice. नहीं नाश्ता वाश्ता कुछ करके आ जाओ. नाश्ता ब्रेकफास्ट यू हैड. डायरेक्टर रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी स्टेटमेंट. ओके व्हेन आई एम डिस्कसिंग ऑफ डायरेक्टर रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी स्टेटमेंट इन डीआरएस एज पर सेक्शन 134 देयर शुड बी सिक्स पॉइंट्स. फर्स्ट पॉइंट आई हैव कंप्लाइड विद अकाउंटिंग स्टैंडर्ड. ओके वी हैव अप्लाइड ओके अकाउंटिंग पॉलिसीज एंड एस्टिमेट्स विच आर रीजनेबल. We have maintained proper and sufficient accounting records. We have complied with accounting standards. Okay, we have ensured accounting policies and estimates are reasonable. We are maintaining sufficient and proper accounting records. We have performed the assessment of going concern. The annual accounts are prepared on the basis of going concern. We have taken care of IFC. What is IFC? Internal financial control, which are related to financial statements again. Okay, they are operating effectively. And last concept, that we have complied with laws and regulation. These are the 6 points you need to mention in director responsibility statement. So in director responsibility statement, there are six things you need to ensure. That director will mention in their board report, one thing, that we have complied with accounting standard, we have complied with accounting policies and estimates are reasonable, accounting records are proper, okay, we have taken care about going concern, our financial controls are stored, and last point, we are complying with policies and procedures. If there is non-compliance, you need to mention in this. And if you remember this thing, if you recall this point, okay, this is nothing but in all, LODR also, we discuss same scenarios. Okay, LODR, when we are discussing from the concept of information, compliance certificate from CEO or CFO, compliance certificate from auditor, compliance certificate from CEO or CFO, we discuss like this only, that we have our financial statements are giving true and fair, which are in accounting standards. There is no fraud. Fraud has not taken place. Okay, that is, matlab controls are effective, na? Okay, and we have ensured that our going concern assessment is very much clear, and that is how the things have worked. But nevertheless, it's compulsory, yeah? But this is also compulsory for companies, director responsibility statement. Everybody clear, Malik? Okay, are hai na? And doubtfully, aayega bhi nahi, audit mein. All this, now whatever one more point is there from audit point of view, nahi hai, law point of view is there. Okay, one is CSR. Okay, I kept the CSR, reason simple because this was newly inserted and the question has not been asked yet. And that's the reason CSR ka point is there. Matlab, I kept this point. CSR. Every company having net profit more than 5 crore or equal to 5 crore or every company whose net worth is more than or equal to 500 crore or every company whose turnover is more than equal to 1000 crore, okay, you need to have CSR committee. Okay, you need to form CSR committee. CSR means what? Corporate social responsibility. CSR committee, when you form CSR committee, you need to understand it should have three or more directors. And out of three or more directors, minimum one director should be independent director. Sir, what is the role of CSR committee? Okay, the role of CSR committee will be, okay, DIM, design, implementation, maintenance, in that scenario only. They will design the policy. They will design the policy, they will recommend, they will provide recommendation and they will monitor. That's the scenario. Okay. What or how the activities need to be focused on, that will be designed by them. They will give a recommendation for expenses to be incurred and they will monitor whether policy is actually working from time to time or not. Okay, this is what you need to understand with respect to the CSR concept. Along with CSR activity, okay, you need to understand, okay, how much amount should be spent to CSR? At least 2% of average net profits of 3 preceding years. 2% of average net profit of preceding 3 years. Yani last 3 years ka total net profit nikalenge, okay, usko average karenge, and out of that average, 2% you should share for CSR. Okay. Preference should be given to local areas. That's your simple concept. Local area matlab, you first give preference in your current area, current scenario, and then you go outside that area. That is something which is called CSR, corporate social responsibility. Okay, this is something which is from auditor point of view, just need to check it out whether CSR committee is formed or not. Okay, whether this particular committee is having that particular committee is transferring this amount or not. If that amount is not transferred, ask the reason why it is not transferred and so on, that's it. Okay, so committee need to take care whether amount is transferred to CSR or not. Okay. CSR activities can be anything. There is no definite point for CSR, but definitely you should do something for welfare of community. Okay, take your corporate social responsibility, you are earning good amount from the society, give something back to the society. That's the scenario. Okay. When we discuss about the CSR activity, okay, there are certain companies, okay, not to be named as such, well, my name case many, but what they did with the CSR activities, there are many areas where lights and other things problems are there in India. Okay, so even if we are saying that lights have been reached, matlab, okay, so our matlab, jo bhi apan baat kar rahe, jinke baare mein baat kar rahe, they are saying lights and other things have been reached, but there are many areas where lights are still not working or functioning well. Okay, so how they define whether lights are there or not? By if there is a board, electricity ka khamba, it means light is there. Light is there or not there, that is not defined. If you are aware how our village is electrified, I don't know whether you are aware or not. Okay, how you will tell that my village is electrified? How they take the counts? This village is electrified. This village is electrified. Electricity is there. It is only by that pillar. Electricity hai ya nahi, that is not a concern for them. If there is a pillar and pura din mein, if 5% matlab kuch unka norm hai, if that percentage of electricity is done in pura year, that means it is electrified. 5% ka norm. Okay. How the roads are defined? Roads are defined, matlab roads ka, I don't know, you are aware how kilometers are defined. Okay, matlab these are norms actually, you should be aware of what actually our government, how they calculate another thing. Okay, how the roads are defined? If this is a road, this is a patch, and this is 10 kilometer patch. Okay, and if roads are prepared for this 10 kilometer patch, and if this is 6-lane highway, 6-lane, the total development is 60 kilometer. Is not 10 kilometer. This is how the kilometers are achieved. Okay, so, and if there is 2-lane, mera, suppose my current road was 2-lane, which is 10 kilometer and 2-lane wala tha, and I made that 6-lane. So my 40 kilometer I added in road. That's the scenario. This is how the things, road development comes into picture. So, yani agar, if you 1000 kilometers of 6-lane highway is done, so how much kilometer you have created? 6000. So you think 6000 kilometers. But it's not a 6000 kilometer. That's actually norms or electrified. Okay, so there were few of the companies which are actually notified, and what they did in certain villages, I seen this in Maharashtra actually, and they have seen actually this, matlab, yeah, let's take it, because maine aapko bataya nahi, I don't know, I travel a lot. I travel by car and I like traveling. Okay, aur jitna time milta na, even if I get 3 days na, I spend that in traveling, I don't sit home. निकल जाता गाड़ी लेके एंड आई डोंट हैव एनी डेफिनेट पीरियड कि किधर जाना है. गाड़ी जिधर मुड़ी उधर गए, रात को रुक गए, ओके उधर रुक गए, एंड आफ्टर दैट नेक्स्ट डे मॉर्निंग निकले, जिधर मन किया उधर गाड़ी घुमाई. दैट्स अ सिनेरियो एंड दिस इज व्हाई, मतलब व्हाई आई एम वेरी हैप्पी विद मनाली, बिकॉज मनाली इज ऑल्सो इन सेम फॉर्मेट, बिकॉज शी ऑल्सो लाइक, मतलब उसको और मेरा बाकी कुछ मैच हो ना हो, बट दिस पॉइंट इज वेरी मच मैचिंग. एंड हाँ, सेम सेम, मतलब इवन व्हाट आई प्लान ऑल्सो फ्रॉम हियर, ऐसा ही प्लान करता मैं कुछ, किधर भी जाने का, लेट सी फ्रॉम वेयर दैट नीड टू बी गॉन, उधर जाने के बाद देखने का, डोंट मतलब आई डोंट प्री डिफाइंड, और ऐसा डिसाइड ही नहीं हो, उधर जाने के बाद ऐसा लगा राइट लेते, राइट ले ले, देखते ना कौन से गाँव में जाते हैं. आई ट्रेवल्ड इन वेरी रिमोट सिटीज ऑफ महाराष्ट्र, वेयर औरंगाबाद के आगे स्मॉल सिटीज आर देयर. Okay, I seen, okay, there were many companies who, because of CSR activity, they've implemented that fan ka concept. I don't know, you are aware, usko kya bolte, I don't know, big fans, they are windmills, okay, and they windmills, they are generating electricity and they are electrifying the villages. Okay, this has been done by them, matlab, and this has been done for, matlab, continuous villages, and this has been, and that windmill does not cost 1 lakh, 10 lakh, aisa nahi hai bhai. It goes in wholesome quantity, crores of rupees. Matlab ye sara. Okay, CSR activity, this is what happened with CSR activities. This can be a best activities. Creating employment, that can be a CSR activities also. It can be anything, okay, how you go ahead, but this is what your CSR activity. Okay, from last 3 years, this question has not been asked, but last time I'm thinking, इसलिए रखा है मैंने, इसके बाद तो I will not teach also. CSR activity, क्या, मतलब if not asking only, why CSR? But what is an afraid, मालूम है क्या, अभी निकाला और वही आया. Examination में CSR, okay. Because there's certain, because anyway, when I'm taking a certain risk, I should be very much clear how much risk we should take and how much calculated risk should be. So calculated risk, I'm already having a calculated risk in audit. Then only I can combine this audit into a syllabus, otherwise, it's an ocean, I may go anywhere, anything can be asked, वो तो scenario गया. But you should be able, capable of answering anything on a general concept or at least a structure-based concept. Okay, that's what you need to keep in mind with respect to your company's point. One more concept which is of companies, okay, there are two concepts actually, one more is liability of auditor and one is CARO. CARO को अपन discussion बाद में करते हैं, right now I'm discussing only liability of auditor. Okay, 10 minutes, it required 10 minutes, 10 minutes का chapter है, okay, you just check it out on the structure, एकदम आराम से, it's very easy structure, okay, one amendment is there and you need to that modify in that notes also, one point, because that is an amendment which is not written notes, okay, so RTP में, current RTP में. Therefore, I may expect this question as in your examination point of view. Okay, when we are discussing a liability of auditor, everybody understand the liability of auditor ka point. First of all, if there is a no loss, there is no concept of liability. If there is a loss, then only there is a liability. Okay, example. Example, when we are discussing about liability, okay, if I have told financial statements are true and fair, okay, and true and fair होने के बाद, actually they are having material misstatement, okay, in financial statement, and at the end of the day, you coming or you are approaching with us, okay, and you are saying, अरे यार, it was not true and fair, material misstatement, and now there is a liability. How much loss you incur because of this? You need to prove that. Then only my liability comes. Unless and until loss is not there, how liability will arise? Okay, example, if suppose I don't tell you that, example, on first day only I made you clear that tax audit ka concern is there and I have taken the calculated risk. There may be a 6 to 7 marks ka risk in your audit ka paper. It may happen that out of all 100 marks, 6 marks you will not be, 4 to 6 marks you may not be able to attempt from our content. That for sure. Okay, but if you focus on 125 marks, it will be very negligible. But aisa ho sakta hai compulsory question mein aaye. Then compulsory question mein aaye and then you are, matlab, I can't do anything about that. Okay. But assume that we have not told anything and I have not taught you one chapter, example, I have not taught you professional ethics. Okay, I have not taught any professional ethics. Okay, and there was no question on professional ethics in examination. Now you are coming, or sir, there is a liability, professional ethics, nahi aaya, sir, I lost, you failed and I failed because of that one. Are? Liability ke liye, there should be loss because of that point. You tell me you failed, na? Agar aisa hota that professional ethics come for 50 marks and you scored only, you written only 50 and out of 50 you are unable to score 40. Okay, then my liability will arise. Professional ethics only came for 4 marks. Okay, theek hai na? Liability arise only when there is a loss. Okay, and that's what you need to understand for an auditor also. Okay, so when we are discussing about liability of auditor, you understand we are discussing the liability from 3 perceptions. One is punter civil liability, one is criminal liability, okay, and one is income tax act ke under liability. Whatever I am drawing the chart is some copy paste of your RTP right now. It's copy paste in your RTP. In your RTP you are having the same scenario. Okay, so there are liabilities of auditor. There are total 3 liabilities. What are the 3 liabilities? One is civil liability, one is criminal liability, one is income tax act ka liability. Okay, civil liability is covered under Companies Act 2013. Criminal liability is covered under Companies Act 2013. Okay, and income tax liability is covered under IT Act 1961. Income tax Act 1961. Everybody clear? This is a liabilities ka set. First liability, okay, sir. First liability when I discuss is about section 35. Sir, what is the section 35? Okay, damages for negligence. Damages for negligence. First liability is damages for negligence. Sir, what is the damages for negligence? मतलब क्या? Okay, misstatement in prospectus. There was a misstatement in prospectus. Okay, here auditor, you will be personally liable. Personally liable without any limitation on liability. Without any limitation on liability. There was a negligence. There was a misstatement in prospectus. Misstatement in prospectus. And logically, because of this misstatement, there were few people who suffered some losses. Okay, now auditor, you will be liable. You will be personally liable. Because I do think you are aware. Okay, when I am discussing auditor. Okay, here. Okay, the auditor can be an expert to the prospectus. When the prospectus are issued, they require that the prospectus should be signed by directors. They should be signed by auditors. So that is an expert to the prospectus. If you are an expert to the prospectus, undoubtedly, okay, you are an auditor of the company, undoubtedly, boss, you are liable and your liability is without any limitation. Without any limitation. I think everybody clear, Malik? Okay, but here you need to understand, if auditor is able to prove, then there will be no liability. What auditor should be able to prove? Okay, if auditor is able to prove that consent was withdrawn before registration, consent was withdrawn before registration. Yani registration honne ke pehle I withdraw my consent. Second, public notice was given after registration. After registration, I came to know about the misstatement. Okay, then I gave the public notice. Are you clear, Malik? Okay, and one of the most important point. Okay, I don't have any reasonable ground to believe that the prospectus was misstated. There are three things. I withdraw the consent, I gave the public notice, and I have no reason to believe that prospectus was misstated. I withdraw my consent. Okay, so I gave public notice after registration, and I have no reason to believe that there is a... Okay, so Malik, everybody clear? Okay, sir. So I'll not be liable in all other cases. Okay, I'll be liable without any limitation on liability. Okay, so this is which liability? Civil or criminal? Civil. Yani imprisonment tak nahi pahunchta tu. See, your civil may matlab kahin na kahin will be less impacted. Criminal will be very serious. We'll discuss about criminal may. Okay, but civil may, there is one more point. In civil liability, there is also damages for misfeasance. Sir, what is a misfeasance? It is a breach of trust or breach of duty. Sir, what are my ethical requirement? As an auditor, what are my ethical requirement? Five. What are the five ethical requirements? Confidentiality, integrity, objectivity, professional behavior, professional competence. Confidentiality was there, na? Okay. You have faith on me, and because of that confidentiality, you gave books of accounts with me, and that books of accounts I shared with multiple users. Breach of trust. Misfeasance. This is what we call damages for misfeasance. I breach your trust. I breach my duty. What was my duty? I breached that. Okay, so you are having a trust, I breach that. Okay, that is called damages for misfeasance. Again, the liability is without any limitation. There is no limitation on liability here. There is no restriction on limitation of liability. Malik, everybody clear? Yani it can be unlimited. Because this depends on... Boy, you imagine that if you are doing the misfeasance, yani you are breaching my trust, how much impacted you are. Okay, on what basis you are impacting me are, and that is called the concept of damages for misfeasance. Malik, everybody clear? Yes or no? That's a scenario you need to keep in mind. This is which liability? Civil. Okay, so how many civil liabilities are there? Two. Okay, and how many criminal liabilities are there? Two. Criminal bhi do hi hai. So civil mein do kaun se the? Section 35, misstatement in prospectus. And damages for misfeasance. Misfeasance means breach of trust or duty. Okay, sir, misstatement in prospectus or untrue statement in prospectus, what is the difference? misstatement in prospectus, an untrue statement in prospectus. Okay, misstatement can be due to fraud or error. Okay, but when there is an 100% fraud, it is untrue. And if it is an untrue statement in prospectus, you have criminal liability. You don't have a civil liability. Civil liability was only for misstatement. Okay, so when we are discussing about criminal liability, your first point goes with section 34. It was section 35 earlier. Here section 24. In section 34 may untrue statement in prospectus. Untrue statement in prospectus. Baat khatam. Everybody clear, Malik? Okay. Sir, how much is liability? Same. Without any liability. Without any limitation. Okay. But you need to understand, okay, this exception is once again applicable here, na beta? What is an exception? If I withdraw my consent, if I have given a public notice, or I have no reason to believe that the information given to me was untrue. Okay, if the three things are there, 100%, again I am bachaunga. Okay, and one more concept is there, and that is what we discuss is about. Okay, second point, we'll be discussing 512 and 612. Now what is the 512 and 612? We'll discuss in professional ethics tomorrow morning. Tomorrow morning, yeah, aega. Okay, I go with certain coding. This is something V.K. Agarwal sir is using. 2005, when I gave my CA examination, so V.K. sir ki first book was there. V.K. Vinod Kumar Agarwal sir. So his first book was there. First book was very small. Matlab hardly 100 page ka book was there. Matlab 120 page ka odd book. That time my CA final first, November 2005. And that time first edition came. It was with Tayal sir in Mumbai. So he was with Tayal sir. So that time that blue color ka and yellow color ka, and in that he taught me this particular, matlab wo point us time pe unhone padhaya. This is the way you can remember. Matlab all professional ethics ke numbering can be remembered with sequential number. Yani there is a clause, there is a part, there is a schedule. So when I say 512 and 612, okay, it says clause 5, schedule 2. Clause 6, part 1, schedule 2. But this is of VK sir, not of mine. So VK sir ki books I understood this clauses. All together, that was very, that time very, very short, matlab short mein, concise mein, he explained that one. So, but that is the scenario. 512 and 62 is about material fact and material misstatement. You are aware about 512 is about material fact and 612 is about material misstatement. 512, matlab apan professional ethics mein kal padenge, clause 5, part 1, schedule 2 says, if there is a material fact, okay, which has not been disclosed in financial statement, an auditor has not highlighted that point, okay, as auditor, you are guilty. Okay, 612, if there is a material misstatement in financial statements, an auditor, you have not taken care, you are guilty, okay, that is, your criminal liability starts, criminal liability. And here, if this point is there, okay, so here, what is an liability? Here, you can get imprisonment for minimum 6 months and maximum 10 years. And how much is a penalty, Ray? Okay, so penalty is, I do think you are aware, penalty is amount of fraud multiplied by? Ma kasam khatam hai kissa. Imagine how much fraud you are doing and multiply by 3. Okay, so you will be paying that penalty amount. अरे पर पीडब्ल्यूसी कितना बड़ा फंडिंग है बे. यू थिंक अबाउट अवर स्मॉल फर्म. पीडब्ल्यूसी इज हाई लेवल फंडिंग, इंटरनेशनल फंडिंग. आर यू थिंक अबाउट पीडब्ल्यूसी एट लेवल? यस, एंड दैट हैज बीन इंसर्टेड आफ्टर दैट ओनली ना. उसके बाद तो वो लोग लाए ना 2013 में. Okay, this is the scenario. But PwC, Big Four will never have a problem with funding. It's a very, bahut bada corporate world hai. Seriously speaking, if we discuss with the corporate world, many times we don't only come to know whether they are telling correctly or actually they are only doing and acting. Corporate world is like this. And that is actually when you enter into corporate world, you come to know. Oh, if you need to reach a top, okay, so you need to understand there should be a corporate culture within you. Undoubtedly, I was an youngest assistant vice president in HDFC Bank. I have been awarded with that. I was a 26-year-old, okay, I was EVP in bank. तो उस टाइम पे मेरे को अवार्ड मिला था. ओके उस टाइम पे दे मतलब द फंक्शंस आर देयर एचडीएफसी बैंक दे डू द फंक्शन अदर थिंग्स इन दैट टाइम. ओके बट थ्री इयर्स आई स्पेंट एंड थ्री इयर्स आई बिकेम एवीपी. इट वॉज नॉट ओनली माई स्किल्स विच इज रिक्वायर्ड. स्किल तो थी भाई, देर वॉज सम कॉर्पोरेट कल्चर ऑल्सो विच इज रिक्वायर्ड बिकॉज आई वॉज नॉट द ओनली पर्सन हु वॉज एलिजिबल फॉर एवीपी पोजिशन. देर वॉज वन पर्सन वॉज वर्किंग फॉर सिक्स ईयर्स. ओके वॉज ज्वाइन बिफोर मी, ही वॉज विद द सेम डिग्री सी ए सी एस. ओके ही वॉज सीसा. ओके क्वालिफिकेशन. बट यू नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड हाउ दैट्स वॉट स्किल यू नीड टू डेवलप. ऐसा डेवलप करते करते और वो तुम काम करना चालू करोगे तो समझेगा. बॉस के इर्द गिर्द घूमना जरूरी है, बॉस के पर्सनल काम होने जरूरी है. बॉस का सम अगर इफ यूर बॉस इज वेरी इंटरेस्टेड इन शेयर मार्केट यू नीड टू स्टडी शेयर मार्केट वेरी थरोली. यू नीड टू गिव द टिप्स टू हिम और वो टिप्स के बेसिस पे द थिंग्स कैन चेंज ड्रामेटिकली. यूर करियर कैन चेंज. दिस इज वॉट अ कॉर्पोरेट कल्चर कम्स एंड वंस यू रीच दैट देन यू कम टू नो वॉट आर द थिंग्स एक्चुअली हैपनिंग एट दैट पॉइंट. और उसके बाद तो मेरे को जो समझा उसके बाद तो मेरे को समझ में आ गया कि बट ठीक है. बट वेन यू आर देयर दैट लाइफ इज ऑल्सो ब्यूटीफुल. मतलब वो भी ऑसम दैट इज लाइफ इज ऑल्सो थोड लाइफ. मतलब इट्स समथिंग डिफरेंट. ओके अमाउंट ऑफ फ्रॉड. बट इफ दिस इज इन पब्लिक इंटरेस्ट फ्रॉड हुआ है द इम्प्रिजनमेंट विल बी फॉर मिनिमम थ्री इयर्स. पब्लिक इंटरेस्ट एवरी क्लियर मलिक दैट्स योर पॉइंट. क्रिमिनल लाइबिलिटी वन इज सिविल लाइबिलिटी वन इज क्रिमिनल लाइबिलिटी. तो क्रिमिनल लाइबिलिटी विल बी हैविंग टू पार्ट्स. What are the two parts of criminal liability? One is untrue statement in prospectus and one is, okay, is 512 and 612. Yani there was a material fact which has not been disclosed and there was a material misstatement which has not been disclosed, which has not been highlighted. Auditor was knowing this fact, there has not been disclosed. And here, this we have discussed the fines amount. And the last part is very important, an LDR for you, undoubtedly, because of amendment. In earlier version or in our book, there is only 3 points here. Okay, but now it is not having 3 points, it is having 4 sections. Matlab 4 parts. Income tax act ke andar, first point, listen carefully. Aram se, first point, okay, income tax ke andar, section 288 say, if you are found guilty under professional misconduct, if you are found guilty under professional misconduct, yani you have done some misconduct professionally, yeah, under Income Tax Act or CA Act, whatever it may be, doesn't matter. Okay, do not represent yourself in front of IT authority. Do not represent yourself in front of IT authority. And you don't go on any behalf of SSEs. You are not required to go. If you go, then you attract penalties. If you are guilty of any professional misconduct, okay, under Income Tax Act or under CA Act, okay, the boss, Income Tax Act, ka section 288 say, don't come to Income Tax Office, don't come to Income Tax Officer, don't come to represent anybody, okay, you are guilty of professional misconduct, okay, and if you come, okay, you are liable, okay, liability will be there, penalty will be there. Second, okay, it is discussing about certain section 278, okay, it says if you submit false document, okay, you are liable. On behalf of any client, you submit any false document. On behalf of any client, you submit any false document, you are liable. Are you doing everything clear, Malik? Okay, in the same scenario, Rule 12A says if you submit any false information to assessing officer, one is false document and one says false information to assessing officer, you are liable. And here liability can extend up to 7 years of imprisonment also. Maximum 7 years of imprisonment. Maximum can be there for 7 years of imprisonment. If you submit false information. For false document, okay, you are not required to worry. Matlab usme bhi penalty hai, but the penalties will not be false document. Penalty will be there, liability will be there. But if you submit false information, information to assessing officer, 101%, you will be guilt, and this will be a criminal concept. Huh? Then your liability starts with imprisonment. Till this 3 point were there already there from earlier years. मतलब जब से मैं पढ़ा रहा हूँ तब से है ये. उसके पहले कब से I don't know. I have not studied in my syllabus, so I don't know about this point. Okay, because Income Tax Act anyway. अपना हाँ हाँ तोड़ तोड़ मीन्स ऐसा हाँ बट वन अमेंडमेंट दे डिड दिस टाइम वॉज वन मोर पॉइंट इफ ओके दैट इज योर दिस हैज बीन इंसर्टेड इन फाइनेंस एक्ट 2017 ओके दिस इज सेक्शन 271 जी ओके इफ यू आर एन अकाउंटेंट इफ यू आर एन अकाउंटेंट यू आर ए मर्चेंट बैंकर और रजिस्टर्ड वैल्यूअर थ्री पर्सन यू आर अकाउंटेंट यू आर मर्चेंट बैंकर और यू आर रजिस्टर्ड वैल्यूअर ओके यू हैव बीन फर्निशिंग इन करेक्ट इंफॉर्मेशन यू आर फर्निशिंग इन करेक्ट इंफॉर्मेशन इन रिपोर्ट और सर्टिफिकेट रिपोर्ट और सर्टिफिकेट यू आर सबमिटिंग इनकरेक्ट इंफॉर्मेशन इन रिपोर्ट और सर्टिफिकेट ओके रजिस्टर्ड वैल्यूअर सबमिट दर इंफॉर्मेशन इन रिपोर्ट ओके यू आर अकाउंटेंट यू आर मर्चेंट बैंकर और यू आर रजिस्टर्ड वैल्यूअर सी ए कैन बी दिस ऑल थ्री ओके इफ यू आर डूइंग दिस ओके assessing officer or commissioner of appeals can ask for penalty for 10,000 rupees for each report which he has submitted which is false assessing officer or commissioner appeals earlier mein there is dekho third mein there is assessing officer only unko submit kiya to second mein with income tax authorities general थर्ड में विथ एसेसिंग ऑफिसर फोर्थ में एसेसिंग ऑफिसर और कमिश्नर अपील्स वेर यू गिवन एनी सर्टिफिकेट और वेर यू गिवन एनी रिपोर्ट ओके एंड इट इज हैविंग ए फॉल्स इंफॉर्मेशन 100% यू आर ओके यू विल बी लायबल टू पेनल्टी एंड पेनल्टी अमाउंट इज हाउ मच 10,000 पर रिपोर्ट 10,000 पर रिपोर्ट विच इज इनकरेक्ट इज इनकरेक्ट दैट्स योर सिनेरियो विद रिस्पेक्ट टू दिस पॉइंट दिस इज यूर अमेंडेड विद रिस्पेक्ट टू फाइनेंस एक्ट 2017 एंड उसका इम्पैक्ट लास्ट अटेम्प्ट में आया था लास्ट अटेम्प्ट एंड दिस अटेम्प्ट तो इट विल बी डिफरेंटली येट टू कम इन एग्जामिनेशन सो इट मे बी आस एज एन ऑडिटर ओके यू विल बी लायबल अंडर इनकम टैक्स एक्ट ओके व्हाट इज योर लायबिलिटी अंडर इनकम टैक्स एक्ट द लायबिलिटी अंडर इनकम टैक्स एक्ट विल बी फोर दैट्स व्हाट यू नीड टू रिमेंबर वन इज 288 रूल 12A एंड लास्ट विल बी ओके 271 जी ओके एटलीस्ट उतना सेक्शन याद रख लो बिकॉज दैट इज एलडीआर otherwise I am not in favor of any sections even when I focus in law and other things only few of the sections you should remember which is very sensitive which is again recurring other than that you should not spend time in remembering this one so standard maybe wo standard ke numbering easy hai other than that agar wo number easy nahi hota na I would have leave only one of the as per one of the standard khatam dimag phodi karne ka nahi your main concept is conceptual clarity it may happen that if you write a wrong section or something like that na to you're over but if you don't write the section na marks ek aadhe dil doge But this will not be case in professional ethics, which we will discuss tomorrow. Professional ethics, you are required to write clause number, schedule number, part number. If you don't write that one, 100% zero marks. So there we need to ratify. We need to ratify. We need to ratify all these schedules. 34 clauses we need to remember all. 34 clauses ko hum log dhyan rakhenge. And if we can remember like this, matlab 111, 211, 311, 411, 511, so on. Aisa scenario rahega. Malik understood? Okay, so I do think, everybody clear Malik? तो हमें सिविल लाइबिलिटी आर देयर टू सिविल लाइबिलिटी में मिसस्टेटमेंट इन प्रोस्पेक्टस एंड सेकंड पॉइंट मिसफीसेंस डैमेजेस फॉर मिसफीसेंस मिसफीसेंस मतलब ब्रीच ऑफ ट्रस्ट और ड्यूटी ओके क्रिमिनल लाइबिलिटी विल बी टू ओके अनट्रू स्टेटमेंट इन प्रोस्पेक्टस और ओके 512 612 मीन्स मटेरियल फैक्ट नॉट डिस्क्लोज मटेरियल मिसस्टेटमेंट नॉट डिस्क्लोज ओके हियर पेनल्टी यू नीड टू रिमेंबर पेनल्टी इज हाउ मच मिनिमम सिक्स मंथ्स ऑफ इंप्रिजनमेंट एंड मैक्सिमम 10 इयर्स अमाउंट ऑफ फ्रॉड मल्टीप्लाई बाय 3 और इफ इट इज इन पब्लिक इंटरेस्ट मिनिमम 3 इयर्स ऑफ इंप्रिजनमेंट एंड इफ इट इज अ इनकम टैक्स एक्ट इट इज यू आर 288 278 रूल 12A एंड लास्ट 271 जी Everybody clear? In last two point, you remember. Okay, second last point, you will remember assessing officer, and last point you will remember assessing officer and commissioner of appeals. उसके पहले first and second में you just remember IT authorities. First and second you will be having IT authorities. Everybody clear, Malik? अरे yes or no? That's the content of your liabilities of auditor. Malik, everybody clear? Okay, I may expect this question in your examination. That for sure, LDR रहेगा. Okay.